Everybody, it's John Stamos.
How are you?
Oh, I'm good.
You like it? How are you doing?
I'm good.
I'm going to do the show from here.
All right.
What's your name?
Janice.
Hi, Janice. Nice to meet you.
I love you.
I love you, too. Can we just do the interview here, Drew?
Absolutely, John. I can make anything work for you because I love you, too.
Nice to meet you. I better go talk to her because it's her show.
Okay.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Yes?
And then come back to me.
Okay, I'll come. You got it. Thank you. We match. Are you in a tie?
Sit that.
I'm so
lovely
happy
took us
to
down.
Be here. I love you so much. And last time I was here was just such you're so kind. You just exude such love and happiness, and I just love being in that vibe with you.
Thank you. First of all, I want to take that in and put it in my heart, and then. Like, you too, you're so, like, giving, and you have this amazing energy, and it's like, okay, here right. we are, we're playful, we're loving, we're affectionate.
We've been in business for so long. How long have you been?
Forever. Since 1980. Well, I started at 11 months old.
I remember.
You, at General Hospital, 1982?
Yes, that's right. But what I was going to say is that these people have kept us in work, you know, working for so long. And it's so great. I was just doing some book signings around, and you really get to meet the real people that are supporting us for over the years. And I just really appreciate all of you. Thank you. It's,
I'm so when you glad wrote, that you feel that way.
I always wanted to be famous, by the way. These people that go, I don't like being famous. I love it. I love it.
I do. I yeah. do.
What's so bad about it? It's great.
I do appreciate, actually, there's a lot of candor in the book because you do admit things like that, which I like, which goes into the big nose Stamos.
Sorry.
No, I know.
I'm going to need a massage therapist.
I was going to say.
I think I threw my butt, my left.
Oh, we're going to get to your butt.
Okay.
So somebody called you
big nose. You know how much pain I'm in right now?
I know, I'm sorry.
Kidding,
is it uncomfortable?
No, sorry, I'm ruining your interview. I mean, the thing you were talking about was that I was, it was before they even had the term bullying, right? And there was a kid, it was, I wanted to sort of highlight this moment when I went from a caterpillar to a butterfly, you know what I mean? Because I was a dorky kid, I was a band geek. And I was into puppets and magic, and girls didn't like any of that stuff. So, oh, there you go, yeah.
Oh, but you don't look like a geek,
well,
John.
You
look like Sean Cassidy. You're, like, totally hot, like that.
But that was as I was turning into it. And I was in marching band, and this kid was playing cymbals, and he said, you know, so-and-so thinks you're really cute and wants to go out with you. And we were in marching, and I stopped, and the tuba guy hit me from behind. I said, you got to be kidding me. And that, you know, it was the first time that I heard somebody, you know, like me. So he said, don't tell anybody, because the sister told me. We were at a block party that night, and I told everybody. And slowly, like a game of telephone, like went from one house to one house. And at the end was her boyfriend, this jock guy, you know. And so I'm sitting in this car with someone else, and he, you know, knocks on the thing. I roll down the window, and bam, popped me right in the eye. And it was so humiliating, so awful. And I had to walk around with this black eye, and I'll never forget. I went into the bathroom, and the kid said, go look in the bathroom. And he wrote, I'm going to kill you, big nose. And I saw that, and I was like, my heart stopped. And I said, I have to do something. I have to do something dramatic and drastic here. I got to become famous. And, you know, and I did. But it took me a while. But this guy, you know, I think that propelled me to be, every step I remember, I'm like, I got to get on TV. I'm going to show him. And I got to play with the Beach Boys. And I'm going to invite him to a concert. And he's going to be backstage. And I'm going to have my bodyguards beat him up. And, you know, none of that happened. I've you know, look, I've matured.
You let go.
I let go. But I'd like to see him one day. And I'd say, hey, man, you know, thank you. You did a lot for me. You really propelled me. And then I'd walk away and say, thank you very much. Then I would stop. I'd say, oh, by the way, you know the girlfriend that the thing? I dated her for about 2 years, and she said you had a small I just wanted to know. Well, she did.
And
you know, you let it go.
Okay, so something that you said in the book that really spoke to me was that you felt like you left being a kid when your son was born. Is that correct?
I think sobering up was you know, what really did it. And I, you know, I didn't have any of the... you didn't either. Like, there was nothing telling us we were adults. We had people taking care of us. We had business managers. We had, right?
Totally.
And
so,
and I always thought being an adult was going to be boring and, you know, everything. And I just went in kicking and screaming. I had this Peter Pan syndrome. But being an adult became just everything I ever wanted. I had Billy when I was 55. I just barely made it.
I, too, knew that I was still too selfish, immature, and, like, I just knew that if there was... I didn't want to screw it up to the best of my ability, so I waited till the last second. How did you have the self-awareness to know?
I don't think I did. I think it just, you know, I started... I never thought I'd write a book. I didn't know what I would write about. I didn't know what my story was. And I really discovered my story as I was writing it. But I started with this first chapter where I got a DUI. It was, you know, it was the worst day of my life. It, clearly, my rock bottom. I almost killed... I mean, I could have killed somebody. Just awful. And the worst part, I realized that I wasn't the man that my parents had raised. My parents were so kind and so how disrespectful am I? So I went to rehab. And I was just like, oh, my God, what have I done in my life? Who am I? This is not who I am. This is not who I am. I was confusing the universe. Like, I was like, why don't I have what I want? You know, a family and a child. So that's what I wrote about first. And my five stages of grief
were... So you cut out that. Like, I cut out drinking, too. Like,
yes,
I'm not
yeah.
sober. I don't work a program. But alcohol, for me, was a poison. And I realized that it was an element in my life that until I was willing to change, things were not going to fall into place.
Right.